Way, way back at the dawn of the new millennium, the BBC and Discovery Channel worked together to produce a documentary series called Walking with Dinosaurs, designed as a filmed-in-the-wild documentary about animals which can't be filmed in the wild, barring a few potential sightings which have yet to be confirmed. It was speculative in a lot of ways. It built itself on theories which were accepted when the documentary was made, but not all of which have stood the test of time, but it still serves as a rather interesting sort of experimental documentary of a sort. And recently, the YouTube channel Dangerville produced its own version called Walking with Godzilla, a similarly formatted video focused on kaiju instead of dinosaurs. The 7.5 minute long video shows us a sort of what-if scenario of Godzilla's past, specifically focusing on the MonsterVerse Godzilla, which means we also get to see the Mutos show up, but rather than seeing them in modern times, we get to see them as they might have been in prehistory. And I have to say, it's very well made. Obviously, it doesn't have the same level of production value as Walking with Dinosaurs because it's an independently produced YouTube thing, but who cares? As long as it's well made, it doesn't need to look that fancy. And it really is very well made. You can tell that a lot of attention to detail was put into this. A lot of effort was put into making this video feel as authentic to the Walking with Dinosaurs experience as possible, just focused on Godzilla instead of Tyrannosaurus Rex. And it paid off. It's really neat to see, and I've always wanted to see something like this. A documentary-style film of a kaiju. Not necessarily found footage. Found footage isn't really the same thing. I'm talking about a documentary, something that actually goes into the greater detail of what a world with monsters would be like. And this delivers. We even get a kaiju fight between Godzilla and a male Muto, and those of you who were disappointed that the 2014 film was constantly cutting away from those fights don't need to worry about that happening here. There are no humans to cut away to in this video, so the focus remains squarely on the monsters from start to finish. And the choices in cinematography are also a nice touch. Again, it harkens back to what the MonsterVerse has done so far, always framing the monsters against things that are recognizable to really drive home just how big they are. Take this shot, for example. Here's Godzilla in the background with sauropod dinosaurs in the foreground. Now, anyone who's been to a natural history museum knows how big a sauropod dinosaur actually is, bigger than any terrestrial mammal today. At least some of them were. Not all of them were, but when they were big, they were really big. So to see these creatures in the foreground being dwarfed by something in the distance, that's a good way to frame Godzilla. If there's anything I can point to that I would say should have been changed, it would be the beginning. We open in the Ice Age with a herd of woolly mammoths minding their own business. Two males appear to be having a battle of rivalry, only for it to be interrupted by Godzilla trudging through. It's a cool scene, don't get me wrong, but it has nothing to do with the rest of the video. It's sort of like we're in the past, and we see where Godzilla existed in this particular period, but then we're going to jump back even further, so this particular part doesn't really come into play just yet. I'm sure it will in future videos, but me personally, I would have either started the video in the modern day as your framing device and then jump back, or just start in prehistoric times in the Cretaceous as the rest of the video is. Not to say that I don't like this sequence, because I really do. I just feel like within the context of this specific video, it didn't really need to be there. But since it is there, it's also just as well made as everything else within it. And based on the final shot of episode 1, I'd say we're in for something very epic come episode 2. So yeah, I think Walking with Godzilla turned out quite well. Minus the false start of an opening, it's a pretty solid video from start to finish, and I look forward to seeing this series continue. Good job, Dangerville. Until such time as we meet again, this is the OmniViewer signing off. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like it as well as subscribe to the channel for more content of a similar nature. Also, check the description for links to our Twitter, DeviantArt, and Patreon pages, as well as the Amazon link for the novel Operation Red Dragon: The Daikaiju Wars Part 1, penned by yours truly. Thank you all, and we appreciate your support.